Hi, I'm Talia Medlin here with PiperCast, and today we're here with Sofia Boru, who has just won the title of Miss Oregon at the USOA pageant, and she's also an instructional assistant here at McNary. How are you today, Sofia?
I'm well. How are you?
I'm great. So what did it feel like when you won the title of Miss Oregon?
It was completely surreal. I was on cloud nine. I was so emotional when I won that I had forgotten that they had to crown me. Mm-hmm. I was so busy hugging everybody and thanking them that they actually had to tell me, no, you need to turn around so we can put the crown on your head.
So when that happened, were all of the contestants very supportive and like
absolutely. Yeah. Everyone was so warm and welcoming when we got off stage so that the next contestants could come out to be crowned. Everyone backstage was hugging and congratulating and was pulling out phones left and right for pictures. It was great.
Yeah. What sparked your interest to be a part of pageants?
I was actually aimlessly scrolling through Facebook one day and I saw an advertisement for a different system and thought, well, I'd always thought about trying pageants. I missed my opportunity here at McNary for Junior Miss. So I thought there was probably a good time to start now and just see how I liked it. And I definitely fell in love.
Mm-hmm. So for Junior Miss here at McNary, when you were a junior here, did you always want to do it?
It was an interest of mine, but I was definitely nervous. I was very shy in high school, and I wasn't very outgoing as far as being driven to do something, any kind of competitions or any kind of competing, going out for sports. I was very, very shy.
Mm-hmm. How many friends have you made in the pageant industry?
Oh, so many. I've made friends with not only the contestants, but I've made friends with the directors, with the cast and the crew, everyone who is a part of the pageant realm. And you meet so many people along the way that even people who are in the audience who have been a part of pageants will reach out to you. If you ever need anything, please let me know. And we stay connected on social media.
So what's your longest friend that you've made in the pageant industry?
My longest friend has been actually Natalie Tonneson. She's a former Miss Oregon USA competitor and winner. She won for 2019. It was her last year before she aged out, and she was the very first friend I made, and she still helps me out to this day. We are actually planning on doing a photo shoot here soon, and she's going to be my hair and makeup artist.
Oh, wow. So speaking about hair and makeup, what kind of preparation do you do before you go to a pageant?
I definitely work with a lot of my coaches. I work with an interview coach, and I work with a fitness coach and a nutritionalist because I do have certain things that I can't normally eat. I do have celiac and lactose, so I have to work around that in the healthiest way. Mm-hmm. And then as far as hair and makeup goes, I do a lot of my own.
Mm-hmm. And you say you'd like to do more of a natural look. Why is that?
I like to stay true to myself. I don't want to look like somebody that I'm not. That when you see a picture of Miss Oregon and then you see a picture of me standing next to that picture, I don't want it to look like night and day. I still want it to look like me.
Mm-hmm. And so when you do gowns and stuff, do you go all over the top or keep it a little simple?
I like to keep it close to my style and my personality. There are times where I look at a glamorous gown and I'm like, wow, that is gorgeous. But then when I put it on, something just doesn't feel right. It doesn't feel like me.
Mm-hmm. And same with your hair. Do you keep it straightened or updo it to make it big? And
I do curls. I like my hair better curled on stage. I do have very thin hair, which is hard on stage, and being able to make it look fuller, especially when you are constantly moving on stage in all different angles, it works better.
Mm-hmm. And so you spoke about your mom being your inspiration for getting into pageants. Would you elaborate more on that?
She raised me and my sister alone. She was a single mom for a long time until she met my stepdad, and he is amazing. I love him. He is my dad. But growing up, I didn't have money. I didn't have the glitzy, glamorous stuff. We went to Goodwill and we went to Old Navy, and we were always taught to work hard for what you want out of life, and nothing is ever for free.
Mm-hmm. And could that be part of the reason, maybe as you were younger, why you didn't think about pageants as much?
Yes, definitely, because pageants do cost money, and there are sponsors to be able to help with that. But when you see someone in a pretty gown, you're like, wow, that probably cost a lot. Mm-hmm. And you don't think about, oh, well, I can reach out to a sponsor and they can pay for it for me. You don't think about that when you're younger.
Yeah. And with your mom being your inspiration, you talked about domestic violence earlier. Did she kind of inspire you to take like interest in helping those people?
My mom and my sister. My sister was a really big advocate because she was freshly out of a domestic violence relationship, and she had seen the cases that I had seen over quarantine, how much that they had increased, and it broke our hearts to see the number of cases that were advertised. And it's hard because there's not a lot of repercussion for that in our industry.
Mm-hmm. And you think that pageants will maybe help get the word out about domestic violence?
Yes, I've actually had 3 different contestants already since I've preached out about a hashtag I've created mm-hmm. for social media as a campaign for domestic violence, asking me, what can I do to help? Can you come to this function? We have this fundraiser. We're doing a run. It's been phenomenal to mm-hmm. see the number of people who are willing to help and to collaborate with that.
Mm-hmm. And so in pageants, is that something you want to work towards, like getting the word out about it?
Absolutely. Everyone uses social media. Social media is a way of marketing and advertising. It's what a lot of young people use today. So I created the hashtag #GetUpGlowUp as a way of advertising that. And so far, it's been a slow trickle, but I have had even people who were at the pageant that weekend when I was crowned ask me about it.
Mm-hmm.
And it was nice to see that it had already been put out there just based on my bio and my preaching out about it on stage during the weekend.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's wonderful. Thank you for being with us today, Sofia.
Thank you.
This is Talia Medlin with Piper Newscast. I'll see you later.